y'all, welcome back, Man With My Hectic Life Pets, where we talk about all things pet and pet related. And today, let's talk about silkworms. So I recently purchased about 100 eggs because I thought this would be a really fun project to do with my daughter. Now this is something that is a fun project that schools often do to kind of learn about the life cycle and life stages. So silkworms do not live very long, and the stages that they go through are pretty fast. So these guys took about 7 days to hatch out of their little eggs, and they immediately want to feed. Now the silkworm caterpillars are only going to eat either mulberry leaves, or they do sell silkworm chows online that you can prepare as directed on the packaging. I am currently feeding actual mulberry leaves. A couple of friends of mine have actually given me a huge supply of mulberry leaves, so I don't even think that I'll need to use the silkworm chow that I purchased, because these guys will eat and eat and eat for about 20 to 30 days. So they're only going to be caterpillars for about 20 to 30 days before they will spin into their little cocoon. Once in their cocoon, then they will be in there for about 2 to 3 weeks and emerge as a moth. Now, sadly, the silkworm moths do not live very long. They are not like a lot of other moths. They will not be feeding after. So once the silkworms emerge as moths, they are designed to do one thing and one thing only, and that is breed. Once they breed and the female lays her eggs, then she will sadly pass away, and the life cycle of the silkworms will continue and start over. So for taking care of these guys are really, really easy to take care of. Right now I upgraded them from their little petri dish into a little jar that I bought at the Dollar Tree. I thought it was a little bit nicer than just throwing them in a tiny little shoebox. And then here in probably a few days, we will be upgrading them into my daughter's 3-gallon little terrarium that she has. Right now they're a little bit too small though. They would definitely be able to get out of the little gaps in there. So you can technically just keep these guys even in a little shoebox. I remember as a kid when we took care of silkworms in the classroom, we did keep them in a shoebox. So you can keep them in a shoebox. Again though, they will only eat mulberry leaves. Now these guys do thrive a little bit better in warmer temperatures. If your house is too cold, they might not grow as quickly, or you might not get as big of a hatch rate. If your home is kept about 75 to 85 degrees, then they will do much better and they'll have a better feeding response and thus a better growth rate. Now, silkworms are a pretty nutritious treat for many different types of reptile species. I don't know that we'll be using them to feed anybody with, because since it is a project that I'm doing with my daughter, I don't want to freak her out or make her upset that I'm feeding our pets with her pets. So they don't really require any substrate. They will get all their water content from the mulberry leaves. So you do want to be putting fresh leaves in there on a regular basis. And these guys will tear through these leaves like crazy. These guys are extremely ravenous eaters. Silkworm caterpillars are designed to do one thing and one thing only, and that is eat. If this is a project that you're doing with your child or in the classroom, then you want to wait until the silkworms are about an inch before allowing the children to handle them, because they are extremely delicate and very small, and they are very, very easily crushed. Now, even when they do get to be about an inch, then you'd still want the children to handle them very carefully, as again, they are still very delicate. They are just a little bit more sturdy. Right now, these guys are like not even a centimeter long. They're very, very, very tiny, easily lost and easily crushed. So the only difficult thing about the silkworm is probably gathering up mulberry leaves or purchasing and preparing the Silkworm Chow that you can purchase online. I'm really liking the idea of just using the actual leaves. It's more natural and I don't have to really do anything other than put a few leaves in there. Now, if you are collecting mulberry leaves, you will want to store them in an airtight container in the refrigerator. I do have a few bags of mulberry leaves in the freezer as well as one in my refrigerator. So that way you can keep your leaves fresh. Otherwise the leaves will dry out and they're not going to be any good for your silkworms. So I'm really digging this nice fun little project. My daughter so far is really enjoying coming and checking and seeing how they're growing and seeing how they're doing, and over you hear the words, oh, they're so cute. But yeah, the whole entire life cycle of these guys is just a couple of months. So an interesting little pet, but very short life. Like I said, this is a fun little project that you can do with your kids or you can do in the classroom, as well as you can use these guys as a nice nutritious treat for your reptiles and amphibians. So that's all for today's video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification so you never miss a video. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye!